Hi everyone, I'm Kay. Welcome to the Ants documentary channel. I'm obviously not the voice of documentary films. That is Jay's voice.
Please, tell me that you won't say that every time.
Yes, now I will. So today, let's talk about medicine in the ant world. Let's check it out. First, you should be aware that ants have developed strong defenses against parasites. One of them is antibiotic-producing metapleural gland. It's a bit like if you always carry your own med lab on you. Useful, isn't it? This gland is ancient, but has been lost in some species. So, question, how can ant avoid disease without it? In order to understand, researchers took this golden shiny ant, Apolyrachis divis, which lacks this gland, and compared it to Formica fusca and other ant species, which all have the gland. They understood that divis ants use their own acid in their stomach to improve their chances of survival while eating contaminated food. In stomach, this acid helps beneficial bacteria like Don't worry, Polyrachis divis will survive. Guys, when you get a little sick, what would you take?
Oh, wait, I do eat chocolate.
I thought more about food supplements and vitamins, but chocolate could do. Humans are not the only species that has invented food supplements. Blackmania is a type of bacteria that is not aggressive. Quite the opposite, actually. It thrives inside the Camponotini tribe. Because a lot of Camponotus species live in trees, they lack amino acids. This bacteria lives in the ant's stomach and completes the nutrition of the ants. Researchers don't know exactly how it works yet, but they can observe that this bacteria and others can help ants with the basic elements they need. Another clever kind of ants are the South American leafcutter ants. They live in symbiosis with bacteria. These bacteria form a biofilm on their body that protect ants' fungal gardens from parasites. These gardens are crucial for ants' survival. Recent studies suggest these bacteria also protect young worker ants from infection. Because it's a biofilm that stays on them, they don't even have to go to the drugstore. You can even see it on their bodies. It looks like white dust. Lucky them! An African ant, Amygoponera analis, is well known for hunting termites. But termites are also well organized and would fight back. During a battle, an ant could be potentially injured. The behavior of an injured ant is amazing. If she needs help, she stays calm and asks for help using her pheromones. But if her body is too damaged to be healed, she avoids help and jumps into the battle. Biologist Eric Frank observed that when an ant has medevac, resistives touch her wound with their feet. Doing so, ants apply antiseptic substance to prevent infection. That leads to 90% survival rate. Quite impressive, right? So far, we thought that this level of medical attention and value for life was a specific human characteristic. But ants prove us wrong again. Let's talk about something even more interesting. Florida carpenter ants are able to perform amputations with a 70 to 95% survival rate. They clean and cut the leg where it fits the best. Researchers compared them with ants who are injured but do not receive any amputations or treatment. Their survival rate drops to between 15 and 40%. Do you realize that ants might have even been the first surgeons on Earth? Okay, that's all for today. Let me know what you think in the comments. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more content. See you next time, guys!